Hey guys, how's it going? It's Ryan, the Immature Dad, and this is my channel. Again, sorry, I know it's been a long time since I've posted anything kind of really IT related where we kind of go over, you know, something. But, you know, I was focusing on doing the interview. If you haven't checked out the interview with Josh, he's a vulnerability consultant. He does a lot of good work. It was a good interview. I will go ahead and put that in the link below, or I'll put a card up here. You know, the little square box thing. Yeah, that thing. But yeah, today we're going to do an actual tutorial. We're going to do a tutorial on how to set up Windows Server 2019. It's just going to be how to set it up and how to join it to Active Directory, how to set that all up for you. This came because a friend of mine was trying to set it up and he was having trouble with it, and I got it set up, but then I couldn't get it set up again for him, and I went back and forth, and I finally figured out how to do it like whenever I want to. So I figured, hey, I'll do a video. It'll help everyone, hopefully. It really helped me. It helped my friend. Maybe it'll help you guys. So let's go ahead and get to that. I hope you guys like the video. Okay, so now you guys should see my computer screen. We are using VirtualBox for this. I know usually, or last time I did anything, I did use ESXi, which is VMware. But for this, I'm going to do VirtualBox just because it's a little bit easier. It's a little bit more accessible for everyone. You know, everything here is free. So everything that I use, I will link in the description. You guys will be able to get. All right, cool. So first thing we're going to do is we are going to create a new VirtualBox, okay? And we'll name it Immature Lab SVR. Then you're going to change the type to Windows. Then you're going to go all the way down till you get to down here. It'll say Windows 16. They haven't put Windows 2019 there yet, so go with that. For your memory size, I would suggest at least 4 gigs. You can do two, but it will run really slow. You'll see in a little bit that even using 4 gigs is going to run kind of slow. So then you're going to go ahead and click create. You can leave it at 50 gigs. You don't really need a whole lot of space for this. Okay. Then what you're going to do is you're going to go here. And actually, let's do this now. We're going to set up a subdomain. Okay. So we're going to click where it says Tools, we're going to go Preferences, we're going to go Network, okay? And we're going to add one, then we're going to edit it, and you'll see that the CIDR is already set at 10.0.2.0-24. You can leave it at that. You know, we just want to be able to connect, okay? You can name it whatever you want, so we'll do Immature Lab. And keep supports IPv6 unchecked. You can keep supports DHCP checked, even though we won't really be using that. So then you're going to go here. You can go ahead. If you have another one, just go ahead and cancel it. And click OK. So then we're going to go here. Settings. Go down to System, 4096. You can undo floppy. And then make hard disk number 1, optical number 2. You can leave that there. You can leave this here as it is, unless you have a bunch of processors. On this particular laptop that I'm using, I only have 2 processors, so it doesn't really make sense for me to switch over. You can leave acceleration alone. Display, you can pump this up to 128 if you want. You won't really notice a big difference. Then what you're going to do is you're going to go to storage. You're going to click where it says empty. And then go here. And then you're going to choose your optical disk. Okay. And then what you want to do is you want to choose the one that is Windows Server. Now, as you can see, I have 2 here, and it's just a bunch of numbers. So this is the one that we want to use, Server Eval. Okay, so we're going to go there. And you want to go down to Network. You're going to enable your network adapter. And you want to go down to NAT Network. Then this is your name. You're going to choose Immature Lab Network, or whatever you decide to name yours. Then you can click OK, and then let's start our VirtualBox. All right, and then you'll see it says Windows Server 2019. You also notice your mouse is probably moving kind of iffy. So you're going to go Next, then you want to click Install Now. Go up here to View, make it full screen. And right now you see it looks like that. We can fix that in a little bit. After we get everything installed. So it'll say setup starting. So pretty much we're going to have to choose which version of server we want to install, which will be Windows Server Standard Evaluation Desktop Experience. So we're going to click that. Then click Next. You just have to accept the license and terms. Click Next. Go ahead and click Custom. And you're going to choose your hard drive space. Click Next. And let's let it install. And while we let it install, I'll fast forward through this. Okay, we're back now. And so after everything installed, you should see your system rebooting. That's just because Windows always reboots. So now we just have to wait for it to start up again. And I will probably fast forward this part too, unless it happens quick. But it should go to our user setup next. After it's done loading. There's the Windows sign. Alright, so we're going to fast forward again. Alright, so, cool. Now, it restarted again, and then it should go to the screen where it asks you to put in a password. So, I'm going to create our password. You guys can create whatever password you would like. Hit enter. And say hello to our server. So, if you want, you have to hit Control-Alt-Delete. You can go down to this menu down here and click Input, Keyboard, and then just choose Insert, Control-Alt-Delete. But it is also easier just to choose Host-Delete or Control-Delete. Sorry, Control-Delete, not Host-Delete. And then you're going to put in your password, and it will log in. So as you guys see, one of the bad things about using a virtual machine is it does use up your system resources, which is why it is taking a little bit longer. So if you install this directly on a system, then it will move a lot faster, but then that system is dedicated to Windows Server, and I don't know how many of you actually want a system dedicated to that. I do also have, like I said, ESXi, which is a cloud, kind of. You set it up on your own desktop. If you guys kind of want to see how to set that up, let me know. I've talked about it a little bit in an earlier video I did. If you guys want to see how to actually set that up and how to set up server or some other version on here, let me know in the comments and I'll do that. So now we're in. It's still going to be loading some stuff. We have some stuff that we have to do before we complete this. So first, we are going to go down here. We're going to go input, or no, not input, I'm sorry. We're going to go devices, optical drives, and we are going to, we're not going to go optical devices. We're going to go insert guest edition CD image. I am sorry. So we're going to go right here. So we're going to go insert guest edition CD images, and you won't see anything pop up on the screen because nothing will happen there. You're going to click the folder at the bottom of the screen. And you guys see I have my volume disabled. So I clicked everything. Everything is still loading. That's, you know, I have a solid state running in this and it's still running this slow. So that is kind of annoying. You can click no to that. Your stuff may move a little bit quicker depending on how you set it up. I think one of the issues is that I only set up one processor. So, yeah. So you'll see server manager and everything pop up. These are all things that will pop up once you start it. I'm just moving ahead. So click this PC. You're going to do the drop down. And then in your CD drive, you should see VirtualBox Guest Editions. And you're going to run it for whatever version of Windows you're using. So we can use this one. But before we do this, what I want to do is I want to set a static IP. Because this is really important. If you don't set a static IP, your IP address could change every time it boots. And if that happens, then your other systems will not be able to connect to the domain. All right? So what we're going to do is we're going to go here. First, we're going to open up PowerShell. And this is just how I do it. You know, if you're a networking genius, I'm not. you can actually set up your own network. You can choose what IPv4 you want, you know, what's your subnet mask, all that. I like to let DHCP handle that first, and then I just copy it all in and make it a static. And just so anyone who's new knows, a static IP address is an IP address that does not change. So there's static and then there's DHCP. DHCP, it pushes out an IP address. Static, you choose what it is, and no matter how many times you reset the computer or whatever you do, it will not change. So we have Windows PowerShell open. Okay, let's pause for a minute. Let's throw another core in here because this is really, really bad. So I'm going to close this out, and I'll be right back. Okay, now we're back. So it's moving a lot faster already. So we're going to log back into the machine. Go to start, and let's go ahead and click Windows PowerShell. Change adapter options. So then you're going to right click where it says Ethernet, click properties. You're going to disable IPv6, click where it says IPv4, right click, or no, just click properties, and then click use the following address. So here, you can just copy this if you want. Control C, go there, and there you go. Subnet mask, that's not the right one, so you want to make sure you get that. You want to use 255.255.255.0. Control C. Just want to fill that in. I'm doing this weird, so go like that. Then your default gateway 202.1. Your default gateway will always be ending .1, so pretty much it's the same as your first three octets, and your octets are going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 after each dot. So your first three and then one is what your gateway is going to be usually. You're going to go there. And then for your DNS server, you want to make it the same as your IP address because we want it to be our IP. So 10, 0, 2, and 4. And then for the second one, you can just do 8888. And then you're going to click OK. You're going to click Close. And then you'll see down here, you have that little yellow triangle that pops up. It'll go away. All right, so it went away. Now we can close that and close that. We're going to open the folder. Go to CD drive. And then go ahead and choose Windows Editions. And what this will do, this will give you the option to use like full screen. So go ahead and click Next, Next, Install. Let that go. And I will fast forward this. Go ahead and just click install for any prompts that pops up. And I'll fast forward. Okay, so now you're going to have to reboot the server. So hit finish and reboot again. I know you guys are tired of rebooting, but it's important when you first start. Okay, so go ahead and go back in. Now we get to the fun part. We get to actually set up our server. So we're going to wait for Server Manager to pop up. We've already set our IP address. Something else we should have done, because we have to reboot the server when we do this, we should have changed the name. So we'll go ahead and make sure we change the name as well. So first, let's go ahead and we can configure this local server. So right now, that's your computer name. That's the work group it's a part of. You'll see that this is your IP address. Now, depending on what you make your IP address, you could have a 192, a 172, 174. It's a lot that you could have. But we will change the computer name now. Click change. Immature Lab SVR. You can name your computer whatever you would like. And we're going to put one, click OK. Click OK, close. Let's go ahead and just restart it now, just to get it out the way. This will be the last time. We will fast forward.